Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Women Speak Out. I'm very excited to have this panel with me today. And Eileen is going to do the actual running of the show. And Beka Jones, who did our music, and it's called Coming Home, isn't it?
I'm home.
Yeah, I'm home. Okay. And she is here. So we're going to start out, and I'm going to let Eileen begin. But we're going to put something up first so that you can see as you're watching and listen and talk to us. We want to put that up. These are some of the things we're going to be talking about.
I can't
okay.
see it.
We can't see it? No. Can you see it? Can we get it a little larger? There we go. Yes, for the old folks. Thank you. Okay. Okay, so Eileen, can you read those, or would you like me to read them for you?
You know, that's good.
Okay.
Now I can.
Okay, go ahead. Thank you, Joan.
Well, one of the things that you're looking at is something I was really surprised at, which are body-shaming comments that are not compliments. I think we've often said these things to each other or to our friends, and without thinking that they really do not mean what they're supposed to mean. One of the first ones on there, we're talking about body image and body shaming, is, have you lost weight? You look great. And I know I've said that to people already. And then when you look at that comment, it means that, gee, you didn't look so great before. You know, you were a little heavier, so that made you not great.
Mm-hmm.
Another one, you are so lucky that you can eat anything and never get fat. The word fat is such a horrible word to use for people. It upsets people emotionally. It hurts their self-image and their self-esteem. Thin people are body shamed just as much as people who are larger size, and they don't want to hear that either, that they should gain weight. Secondly, it says you really should eat a burger. That's really not a compliment to someone. It's telling someone that they are too thin and they're not attractive. Again, you're just undermining someone's self-esteem by making comments that you think are compliments and they're not. Another one is real women have curves. And here we go again. You know, what do you mean? If you're thin and you're flat and you're not curvy and you're bony, does that make you not a real woman? Again, it's really not a compliment. She's all flat. Again, we're talking about women. You know, your breast size isn't what's important in a person's body image. It's your overall healthy look and your attractiveness. It's within. It's not the outside. Looks like you have gained weight in all the right places.
That's
not sure what that means.
Yeah.
You know, that's an obvious, looks like a compliment. It may sound like a compliment, but it's not the right compliment. I've heard this one many times. You have such a pretty face. You would look a lot better if you lose a few pounds.
You know that, like, one, Becca.
I've heard it.
Yes.
Yeah. You know.
Yeah. I've heard that since I'm probably 13 years old. Not that I have a pretty face, I'm not saying that. But your family even said it to me. My family said it to me.
That's right.
You have a pretty face. Oh, you just, if you lost a few pounds, you even look prettier. Again, not a compliment. I've said this too to many women. That just makes you look so skinny, I just love it. Well, what does that mean as well? You know, it's looking skinny makes you a better person? Not necessarily. It does not. And one of the last ones, you are so brave for wearing those clothes. Again, it is not a compliment. It is an insult as to what you chose to wear. Well, you choose to wear, you choose to wear.
Right.
If you're comfortable in it, in your body, then it is fine.
That's right.
It is fine. And nobody should be complimenting you or even commenting on what you're wearing.
Yep.
At the time, and you just the way you want to adjust is what I'm saying.
And Eileen, thank you for finding that, because we all have done that, haven't we?
Even to our friends.
Yes, and trying to say that we were trying to give them a compliment, but once again, it's all based on the size of your body, whether you're thin or whether you're heavier, and also what parts of your body are supposed to be accented and aren't supposed to be accented.
Right.
So, I mean, that's what we're trying to do here today. So, Eileen, you want to give us something to talk about?
Yes, it is. There's a lot to talk about.
Yeah,
that's
there's
for
a lot.
Sure.
24 minutes.
With body image, I got some facts here that I was really surprised, and maybe not so surprised, but being a little bit older now, I know growing up, I had said in the last program, I had going on diet pills at the age of 13 because my pediatrician wanted me to lose weight and thought I couldn't do it on my own, and they were pushing me to lose the weight and had me on speed, basically, at a young age. And, of course, my mother just went along with it because in those days,
the doctors know and the doctors rule.
Yeah. So that was not a good thing to start me off. And it gave me that image in my own mind that something was wrong with me, that I was overweight and I was heavy. Heavier than my other, you know, neighborhood girlfriends that I grew up with.
Right.
I remember one young lady in our neighborhood whose mother made her not eat. You know, was always on her about everything she ate. She was always harassed by her mother, and I never understood that her mother was even doing that to her. My mother did not do that, but she was concerned that I never lost my baby fat.
Okay.
That was another thing they would tell you. Okay. Oh, just wait, you'll lose your baby fat as you grow up. You'll be fine.
So you know. Basically, also what you're trying to say, too, is if I think about what you're saying, with my father always watched what my mother ate. And then she would sneak food, okay?
Yep.
So this is what I was seeing.
Right.
And what kind of thing is that for me to learn?
Exactly.
Okay?
Exactly.
So a man is actually telling you how you're supposed
how you
to
should
eat.
Look and how you should eat. Yes.
Yeah, that's, and Becca, have you ever run into that?
First time I tried Weight Watchers, I was 8 years old. Mm-hmm. So I've always, this is me, this is how I've always looked. Mm-hmm. From the get-go, like, this is my body. And I've, you know, long since come to just accept it. Thank God I've gotten to that. But yeah, my mom grew up with, my grandmother was raised, you know, in the Bronx in the 30s and the 40s, and she's this big, and still to this day, 93 years old, drives to Weight Watchers to weigh in.
Wow.
So yeah, it's a lifetime. It's been a lifetime of that. And my mom, God love her, grew up with that. So she, like your mom, would never force me to do any of that. It wasn't that she was making me go to Weight Watchers, but I remember my mom losing over 100 pounds when I was like 3, 4, 5 years old on Weight Watchers, and that like was one of my first memories. Was a constant memory. It was just her watching what she ate, weighing things, and it just seems crazy to me.
Yeah.
Well, and I'm, believe it or not, I am a lifetime Weight Watchers member since 1969.
Wow.
When I was 19. And so when I first started going to Weight Watchers, and that was the other thing too, my entire life, I gained it, I lost it. Yep. I gained it, I lost it. Huh. I spent thousands of dollars, and many of us women, there's a few men out there too, don't get me wrong. There are men out there too that have the same issues of body image, that they're uncomfortable with their weight too, and they were at Weight Watchers as well. And Weight Watchers is a good, healthy program. I'm not downing that. It's just that it is a lifetime commitment then, because I truly believe after going up and down the scale for 7 decades, basically, that my body wants to be a certain weight, and that's what it wants to be.
Yep.
Now, my disclaimer here, too, is I do not propose that you should not lose weight if you're diabetic and you need to lose some weight because your sugars are high and you have to watch your carbs and things for health reasons. If it's a health reason, then I understand. Mm-hmm. You need to get the weight maybe down to get your blood pressure down or your sugar down. I understand that part. But when it's just the body image and you're healthy, you feel well, your doctor says you're well, then, you know, you can't keep killing yourself trying to lose weight, or if you're very thin, trying to gain the weight to try to meet some social norm that they want from you. And sometimes, it's not just the men, sometimes the women are the meanest towards each other when it comes to that. You think that you have to be a certain look or a certain size, or, you know, God forbid you're a 14 and not a 2.
Yes, exactly.
When I was growing up, there wasn't such thing as zero or two.
There wasn't such a thing as a 2 or a 0.
Something's changed. If you were a 4 or 6, you were thin.
Yeah.
But I have some statistics there that at the age of 13, 53% of American girls are unhappy with their bodies. And this goes to 78% by the time they're 17. So that's kind of sad that you're 17 years old and 78% of those young ladies are not happy with the way they look. And I think that's because of social media and the pressure that they find themselves on from their friends, from what they're seeing on Facebook, on TikTok, on commercials, whatever it may be. The whole Hollywood look of, you know, looking a certain way, they're just trying to achieve things that aren't natural. So I get concerned about that. 50% of teens are self-conscious about their bodies. 26% are dissatisfied. What was interesting is by age 60, now here we are, age 60, 28% of the women still feel dissatisfied and are self-conscious about their bodies. And you get to the point, like, at what point can we just be happy with what we are? Mm. That's my yeah. concern and body image. And I would like to see us get to the point where if everybody else doesn't think you're beautiful, just so you think you're beautiful and you have the inner beauty inside, you're happy with your body, you're content with the way you look, that's all you need. You don't need everybody's approval.
It's hard though, isn't it?
It's very hard.
It's very hard. Because I swung from, I was an anorexic, okay? So, but then I would swing up into weight because my body didn't lose the weight. It went into emergency mode. Mm. And then I got heavier and heavier, but I wasn't eating much, okay? So there's that reverse that goes the other way. And I have buried so many women who die from anorexia. I mean, because they
starve themselves to death.
They starve themselves to death.
Exactly.
And what was inside those people, those women, was a learned behavior, like you talked about with your grandmother, and you talked about with your father was my father.
Your
and,
father.
And yours was who was
my,
the?
It was well, mine was a cousin's.
Cousin.
My cousin.
Okay.
Yeah, one of my cousins.
So
well,
you know,
a number of my cousins. We were all heavier.
What we see and how it manifests is how we learn. Then how do we get to understand that we are beautiful and different varieties and it is a spice of life. Yeah.
Exactly.
So, but I mean, what do you think? You're younger than us, so talk to us about what you think.
I've grown up always being the heaviest in my circle. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't know why that is or whatever. This is how God made me. Here I am. But,
exactly.
You know, it is tough when your girlfriends are like, let's go shopping. And I'm talking more like high school age, you know, like all the rage was going to Abercrombie or wherever. I could never fit.
Okay, right.
Never fit into them. And it still makes me upset that stores today don't have what I consider normal size clothing, that I have to go to a plus size place where they make clothes for they don't make clothes that are fashionable, in my opinion.
No.
You know, and why do the stores think that us large women want to dress in muumuus? Like, I don't see the disconnect.
Exactly.
So I've just gotten a thicker skin and being a musician and, like, forcing myself, really, because nobody's making me do it, forcing myself to put myself out there.
In public, yep.
That's when I'm most confident. And when I'm confident, I feel beautiful. And I think that if you feel confident, like you were saying, you feel beautiful with yourself and in your skin, people are gonna think you're beautiful too.
Right.
It's
absolutely
not the makeup, it's not the Louis Vuitton, it's not the clothes.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's how
yeah.
you carry yourself.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
It's how you present
yeah.
yourself. It's your personality,
yeah.
it's your inner spirit. And you know, growing up, it's been a battle for many of us all our lives. To constantly be fighting this, and you finally get to a point where it's like, I just can't do this anymore.
Mm-hmm.
I can't do this anymore. It's time to just accept what it is. I gain weight sometimes, and I lose weight sometimes.
Yeah.
Sometimes it just comes off depending what's going on, you know. But it's
and
a
your
struggle.
Body, you're right, because you brought a point up that said your body knows what they want, what your body wants your weight to be.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And I'm a nut when it comes to 3 pounds over that scale. See, because I'm crazy in the head.
Because you were trained that way.
Because I was trained that way.
Right. Yeah.
Okay.
To be a certain weight.
So
certain
if I
size.
Start seeing 3 pounds, okay, and then I don't eat.
Oh.
Okay. This is a problem, a very big problem.
And this is when your metabolism shuts down often. Because it goes into survival mode and you won't lose weight.
No, you won't, because then actually that's what happened with me. I gained weight. So, I mean, but how do we then as women, I guess that's Eileen, you tell me what you think, because you're a smart woman. what do you think, I mean, how do we then change our feelings about our own bodies when society is indicating that we are sexual creatures that have to look a certain way?
Well, I think it it's something you have to, as a woman anyway, I think you have to get to a certain point where you decide that, okay, I've tried this, I've tried that. I can't maintain that weight. That weight's never going to get maintained because I'm never going to be happy. Mm-hmm. And another thing that happened to me, which I remember very distinctly, my mother was a larger woman. She was like 180 pounds, and she got ill. Mm-hmm. My mother got ill and had to have a very major surgery where she was in Massachusetts General Hospital for this surgery, and she got lost a tremendous amount of weight. Over her lifetime being ill, she got thinner and thinner and mm-hmm. thinner till she was down to under 100 pounds, and we couldn't get her to eat because of her illnesses. Mm. And she would always say to me, be thankful that you can eat, because she could not eat anymore. She was at the point where she had no interest in food. It made her ill when she ate because of her medical issues that she had. And she said, you just don't know how lucky you are that you can eat what you want. Just eat what you want. Mm. And an old friend of mine was a psychologist. I used to do some work for her when I was younger, and she was older. And she said to me one time, always keep 10 pounds on you. She said, one day you're going to get sick. And your body needs to feed off of it. If you're ill, and you know, it's like when you have the flu and things like that, where you're not eating, and you know, you can drop 5 pounds real quick. Mm-hmm. And if you come down with a serious illness and you're not able to eat, or you're not able to take in the food like normal, the weight comes off. If you have no weight to come off because you're so thin already, mm-hmm. you're not going to survive. Mm-hmm. So that little bit of extra weight, it's almost like survival mode. And I believe that goes back probably to the caveman days, you know, where they carried extra weight on them and to survive the cold and the harsh conditions they lived under.
It's been it has definitely been studied scientifically that the survival is what's in the body.
Exactly. And, your body needs some extra, not saying a lot, but you can do it. I think you need to get to the point. If I feel any woman is attractive and will be attractive to men, if that man sees them, the beauty within, their personality, their love of life, mm-hmm. their interests, their concerns, the way they are treated, the way they treat the male that they're with, all that's a beautiful thing. It has nothing to do with your size.
Yeah, nothing to do with your size. Unfortunately, that's the reality. Because Beka, as a performer, mm-hmm. I have to ask you a question. You know, when you go and perform. And you contact a place to be there. Does anybody ever?
No, I've never.
Show any?
I've never had any of that, thankfully.
Discrimination against you?
Not against the way I look. I think more I have trouble because I'm a woman than a guy getting in. You know, I run into that very frequently. Mm-hmm. Or my husband helps me bring all my gear in, and then immediately everyone assumes he is the musician.
Guy. Yeah.
But. Yeah. Yeah, he shuts that down real quick. Yeah. He's like, you don't want to hear me singing. But fortunately, no. But, you know, of course, when I had my professional photos done, I'm mm-hmm. thinking of all of these things, getting the angles, you know, stretching the neck and the chins and so forth, because you want to present yourself in such a way, you know? Like, I idolize people like Kelly Clarkson and Lizzo, mm-hmm. who finally just put their hands up and like, this is me.
Right.
This is beautiful.
That's it.
Exactly. That's it. There's nothing else. There doesn't need to be any more discussion.
Yeah.
Exactly.
And brave women changing sometimes.
But we need to start with our young women.
Yes.
Our young children. We need them to start young.
My niece is 13 years old and already starting down the, I look this way, I look that way. I'm chubby. And my cousin and I, we look the same. And we're like, listen, girlie, this is you.
This is
us. This is our blood.
Yep.
Yeah. So you need to love it, not hate it.
Yeah. So we're really talking about body image and loving ourselves, which mm-hmm. is extremely difficult.
It is.
But then also the other piece that I need to bring up is the eating disorder piece. Now, that's a whole separate topic, really, but it's coming from the body image in regard. But when we're talking about people who have addiction issues, so, for instance, anorexia, I mean, none of that was in the DSM that would be our guide as a diagnosis for people. Food addiction wasn't, that's funny.
Really?
Just stop eating, okay? you know, okay, alcoholics, narcotics, okay. But food is not an addiction.
They think it's a choice.
So we had no access of diagnosis mm-hmm. for that. And I was just like, what the are you talking about? Because alcohol is a sugar addiction. Mm-hmm. It's all sugar. Okay. Mm-hmm. So if you're looking at people with eating disorders, it's sugar. Okay. Mm-hmm. So the idea is that we finally got that. I guess that was in the 90s where we...
They finally gave me the DSM-5 or whatever it is.
So we're not saying that everybody has an eating disorder, but it's a fascinating thing for me to figure out that, okay, we're looking at body image and how we feel about ourselves as women. And then we also now have finally been validated that there is a mental capacity to that. And I've always wondered if it is because of the actual sugar addiction, or is it actually something to do with body image that mm-hmm. made us mentally go wacko?
Wow.
Do you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And I'm not saying this in a bad way.
Right.
Because I am a recovering addict. The idea is, it's like, does it then morph into a disorder because, you know, we bought that message of, you know, of, I don't know.
I'm not thin enough. Well, anorexia, I mean, as you know, being a therapist, that they, as thin as they are, they don't see themselves that way.
No.
They can't.
No, mm-hmm. no.
They look at Karen Carpenter, I always think of her.
Yes.
There's a perfect example.
There's many women that died mm-hmm. from
that. Yes, and she was so talented and so beautiful.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
And it killed her.
Yeah, so, you know, it's a fascinating thing, but I just wanted to do the eating disorders because we'll do that another time. But what I really am excited about Eileen talking about this body image is because we have to start to get to our youth.
Yes.
And put the finger in the dam before it really, because mm-hmm. it's now... Yeah. really becoming almost impossible.
One of the things that I have on here, and I thought this made sense, it was how to help your body image.
Yeah.
And it's de-emphasizing the numbers. Neither weight or your body mass index tells us anything. And eating habits, activity patterns, self-care choices are much more important. Stop comparing yourself to other people.
Yes.
Your physiology is unique to you. You can't get a sense of your body's needs and abilities with someone else's body as a reference point. And research has shown that frequent comparing trends to increase negative body image. So it's so much is blasted at us through the media.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And through your friends sometimes mm-hmm. in social life that you need to be a certain look, a certain kind, a certain size. It's not true.
Yeah.
So if we can get young people to understand that they're going to be fine. They look beautiful the way they are. They have choices they can make. Yeah. And stay healthy, eat well, but don't starve yourself to death. And if you are heavy, don't worry about it. Maybe that's what you have to be.
You know, you're happy.
I'm a curvy girl.
Yeah.
I'm fine with it.
You brought a good one up with media. The media is killing us as women.
It does. Okay. It puts so much pressure on everybody.
You know, that's the thing. I mean, how for you, Becca, you're a different generation than us, okay? So... we're going to close in about 3 minutes, but what do you feel, you say you got to a place mm-hmm. of knowing that you're beautiful as you are, but there's still, I'm sure, voices in your head, right?
Yeah, when you just look around and you see how many people have their lips filled and their noses done, and I'm like, you're not even 30.
Not real.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I don't know where, like you said, I think we need to start grabbing these girls sooner and saying, you know, that's your nose. It's small. It's cute. Love it. Like, you have a curvy nose. Who cares? Yeah. Barbara Streisand's gorgeous, and
yes,
no one got it.
Sing because of that.
That's
nose.
Right. So but the media, it is. It's like, you know, you've got families like the Kardashians, and that's just not a realistic expectation for someone to look that way.
It doesn't. And Eileen, is there anything you want to say closing before, because we got about 2 minutes now?
No, pretty much we just wanted to bring out that body image is important, and you should be happy with the way you are. Learn to love yourself. People will not love you if you don't love yourself first. Mm-hmm. You've got to love yourself.
Yeah.
And you have to accept who you are and be happy with that. There's nothing wrong with that. I don't care if you're thin or you're heavy. It mm-hmm. doesn't matter. That weight has nothing to do with your life. unless, like I said, if you have a health issue, that's a different story. We'll talk about that some other time.
Yeah.
So my word to young people is don't stress so much over it.
Right.
Try to be happy. Try to keep, you know, love who you are. That's pretty much it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Same with. I'm glad we have someone younger here because I'm a lot older. Been down this road for a long time.
And we thank Becca.
Yes, Becca, thank you so much.
Thank you for having me here. We're now starting this with having a guest to go with this.
But before we close, I'm just going to read this. I found this morning, which is bizarre. It was on my Facebook. But evidently, this woman's name is Becky Hemsley, H-E-M-S-L-E-Y. She wrote this poem, and she's from the U.K. So, hi, U.K. I used to live there. So, anyway, here's what it is. When we are young, we want to look older. And when we are old, we want to look younger. And there is a window in the middle of it, all when we're supposed to look as we wish. Okay? But we waste that time wishing we were taller or thinner or curvier, our hair was longer or shinier or curlier, parts of our body were firmer and perkier, and we started to use anti-wrinkle cream early. And by the time we realized we were perfect just as we were, the window has closed. Mm-hmm. It's too late to realize that all those things never really mattered in the first place. And this is what echoes you, Eileen. But it's never too late to start letting go, to stop wanting, stop wishing. It's never too late to accept yourself, to look in the mirror and realize that all along you never needed to look older or younger or anything else. You just needed to look like you. And it gave me the chills when I got it this morning, so I sent it to Eileen.
It's perfect. Things happen.
Synchronicity happens.
Yes, absolutely sums up what we're talking about.
So what it is I, again, before we close, we just wanted all of you to know that we want to have you learn how to love yourself, but we as women have got to say, you are beautiful.
That's right.
Okay, you look fabulous.
That's right.
Yes. Okay, and you are gorgeous, and I'm so glad that you're in my life. And and that kind of affirmation does work, don't you
Absolutely.
Think?
Absolutely. So we need to support each other and put our hands out.
Yeah, definitely. So thanks very much for both of you.
Oh,
and
thank
Eileen,
you.
Thank you for taking this topic on.
My pleasure.
And we say thank you to
you.
And again, thank you. We'll see you soon. Women Speak Out. Bless.